Have you ever failed at something with a thought of giving up because you didn't think you would ever succeed? Well, for L.I.G. and Fitzgerald, failure was not an option. This ambition and mentality led her to become the most popular female jazz singer in the United States for more than half a century. She became known as the First Lady of Song and the Queen of Scat. Ella Fitzgerald was born on April 25, 1917 in Newport News, Virginia. Originally, Ella had wanted to become a dancer and performed on the sidewalk for people passing by to see. When her neighbors saw her talent, they told Ella to go to New York, and that was when her career in showbiz began. On November 21, 1934, Ella entered a talent contest at the Apollo Theater when she was 17. But when it was her turn to show everyone what she could do, she froze and her legs became jelly. She didn't want to fail, give up, and return to Yonkers, so she started to sing. Ella sang really well and won the contest straight up, so she decided to give up on dancing and become a singer instead. Not long after that, Ella went on to win talent showcases all over Harlem, New York. In January 1935, Ella had a chance to perform for a week with the Tiny Bradshaw Band at the Harlem Opera House. It was there where she met Chick Webb, the leader of one of the dominant big bands of the swing era. Even though he was impressed with her voice, he wasn't sure if he wanted her in his band, as he already had a singer. Reluctantly, he decided to give Ella a chance. She would sing with his orchestra at Yale University, and if she could excite the crowd, she could join his band. Luckily, Ella was a huge success, so Chick stayed true to his promise and hired her to travel with his band called the Chick Webb Orchestra. Chick's band played regularly at the Savoy Ballroom, and every time the place was crammed with people who came to dance while Ella sang and Chick played the drums. When Chick died in 1939, the band was renamed Ella Fitzgerald and her famous band. Ella Fitzgerald died on Saturday, June 15, 1996, at her Beverly Hills home at the age of 78. The cause of death was not disclosed, but Ella suffered from heart disease and diabetes for many years. If there's anything to learn from Ella's life, it's to not give up despite all the challenges that you may face. Ella said it best, just don't give up trying to do what you really want to do. Where there's love and inspiration, I don't think you can go wrong. This book was written by Andrea Davis Pinkney and illustrated by Brian Pinkney. You can find this book at your library or at the JS Library.